Welcome to the Holy Yogi, where we help you find the guru inside of you. Hey beautiful, hey handsome. If no one has told you today that they love you, let me be the first. Give you that cyber hug today. Today is the beginning of a brand new year, and all of us want to tap into that guru inside of us to live a more prosperous, abundant life, to basically get to the level of a better, healthy, wealthy, and wise one. So in order to do that, what I'm going to do today is teach you the 3 steps on how to become a holy yogi for beginners. Let's keep it real simple. By first reminding you, what is the holy yogi? What is it all about? What is the true essence of who and what you are? Because a lot of us have forgotten. You are purity. You are bliss. You are peace. You are love. You are knowledge. You are power. You are happiness. Yeah. So tap into that aspect of you. One of the key words, there are 3 steps. Number 1, it is affirmation. Number 2, via visualization. And number 3, via meditation. And not necessarily in that order. But we're going to begin with number 1. We're going to talk about basically meditating. And meditating, through meditation, that is our opportunity for prayer is our conversation with God, and meditation is God's answer back to us. It is the medicine for the mind, for us to reconnect with the divine force and spirit within inside of us via silence. So one of the key things that you want to do is you want to, on a daily basis, you want to build that spiritual muscle, where you gotta exercise that muscle on a daily basis. And I tell you why it's very important. You know, I had an opportunity to actually see a yogi who, through Raja Yogi, and they call her sister DJ. And in a nutshell, she's 103 years old, ladies and gentlemen. At 103, you would think she'd have it down to a science, and she'd been practicing it for 83 years. And to this very day, she rises early every single morning, just like a beginner, just like you and I, and practices the same tenets of at least 20 minutes a day of getting spiritual readings and lessons, going into meditation, doing the affirmations, and visualizing the type of day that she wants. So before we even begin with talking about meditation, we want to really establish with you that this is something that you consistently have to do every day. And you probably say, why? Well, the same reason why you take a shower every day. Because you want to clean out all the dust and dirt and grimes and viruses and funguses that may have accumulated over the day. So we've got to cleanse, we've got to purify the body. And it's the same with the spirit. Every day we get negative information and education that comes into our minds through the people, places, and situations, circumstances that we're experiencing. So every day we've got to get rid of the falsehoods and the untruths, the anger and resentment and the fear and the anxiety and the stress that's out there in the world, and get back into our divine spirit of who we actually are, in a place of prosperity and abundance and love and light and compassion and truth and justice, righteousness and order and balance. So in order to be able to do that, we gotta replenish ourselves on a consistent daily basis. Cannot eat, you know, just one meal a day, or not eat at all in order to be able to replenish our body. Same thing with our spirit. So with that said, you want to meditate. And in meditation, you go into silence to connect. whatever that affirmation is for you today. And in being a place of the I am state, the places I am that I know that I am, this is the Bible, it's in the Bhagavad Gita, it's in the Quran, it's in all the great spiritual books. That goes into the essence of your true nature, of who you naturally are. And so today our mantra is, I am love. I am love. I am love. So you want to say that affirmation 108 times. That's number 9, means completion. So you can do that on a consistent daily basis to bring the light and love of affirming that you are truly loved. Now as you affirm that love, what you want to do next is you want to visualize people without vision. To all those people. And then in addition to that, to the experience, what happened, I exude that high vibrational frequency. And as I put that love out, the objective is real simple. What you give out to the world, you shall receive back in return from the world. That love comes back. And it truly is that love that makes the world go round. And so you have what? A lovely day. So that is an illustration of how you could be in control of your whole entire destiny by defining the love and the life that you want to live. So let's go over that one more time so we can have a lovely day and be in control of our destiny. Oh, isn't this a lot of fun? Yeah. You have the power. You have the source. You have everything you need to be the holy yogi and live a yogi lifestyle. Peace and joy and of happiness by basically making a decision and a commitment every single day of your life to be just that. So the way that you get there is number one, visualization. Number two, affirmation. And number three, go to that meditation to seal the deal with the divine universe. So upon you, that aura, that light that you created upon you is going to transcend out into the world, and it's going to be a holy yogi day for everybody that comes in contact with you. Thank you so much for being a part of the Holy Yogi Day today. I want you to have a Holy Yogi Day, and so at the end of this day, a couple of things I'd like you to do. Like this page today, subscribe, and also place a comment so you can spread the word by spreading the love. And I promise you, you spread wealth of health, wisdom, and happiness. Love you. See you tomorrow.